I got a doozy, like the next day. A really bad one.
I thought my life was over.
The pain that never, you know, is unrelenting.
Pretty much wanted to eat a bullet. You know, having herpes is like, it's like being punched in the face every time you complain about being punched in the face.
And so it's not that if you suffer with herpes, you're suffering more than somebody who has cancer or, you know, HIV. But I think it's safe to say you're probably suffering just as much.
These patients are very, very depressed. And they can't tell anybody.
That's that part of the disease where nobody really has any answers.
No one would ever want to, like, talk to me or date me because I have this.
I was like, yeah, yeah, whatever, vaccine, yeah, okay, it's just more bullshit. And she gave me some paperwork to read, and she said, you know, this Dr. Bill was really doing something.
I came across Bill's research. It was like this thing that nobody had found.
So at this point in time, it's like becoming clear, like, okay, this is radically different than what's been failing previously. Oh, if I put them head to head with the big pharma subunit vaccine strategy of the last 30 years, it works about 100 times better.
The end result of not being in pain anymore seems pleasant.
Hey, the number of people manufacturing biologics in the 60s was probably 10 to 100 fold greater than the number doing it today. And the reason why is because nobody can afford to get past this regulatory hurdle. And what they did is create $50 to $100 million of paperwork for anyone to even test a new biologic in a single patient.
We need change that'll put a premium on scientific skill in developing breakthrough medicines, and not so much a premium on skill in dealing with the FDA bureaucracy.
It's rational vaccines. They're trying to develop a therapeutic for this herpes virus. Nobody's ever done that before. With such an unconventional team like Bill and Augustine is, are these guys completely mad?
Many of us in academia kind of think that ultimately what our goal is to help the patients in whatever our area of research is. Bill for sure epitomizes that.
We really, truly did not either of us think he had a year.
It's called cytonasal undifferentiated carcinoma. The 5-year survival times are not inspiring.
It's finding a guy who said, man, I'm gonna die before I can really prove that this works.
So I vaccinated 3 members of my family. If we didn't have a problem, you shouldn't have a problem. And this approach has worked every single time it's ever been deployed in the last 220 years of medicine. So why wouldn't we at least just try it?
The doctors have run out of treatment options for him.
He recognized a problem and he wasn't giving up. That's just so unique, right? He wasn't letting anyone stand in his way.
He could care less about business, he could care less about anything. He cares about making a difference with his science.
Augustine and Rational Vaccines will succeed with or without me. And that's really been my goal, is just to get those guys to the point where they don't need me.